All right, let's continue our discussion of adding rational expressions. When we were giving you problems of this type, what we said is to make common denominator, look at this denominator and this denominator, multiply the first one by the second denominator, top and bottom, to make equivalent fraction, multiply the second rational expression with the first denominator to make common denominator. This is when we were overlying the grid. Do you remember that when we were doing simple fractions? So this is how we introduced, and then of course you'll multiply it out and finish it off. Pretty soon you'll realize that when numbers on the denominator are really big, this becomes a little impractical, and perhaps there is a smaller common denominator that works, and that's called the least common multiple. So we'll talk about what multiple means, we'll talk about factors and some other concepts of that type. When you're working with polynomials, you'll again do the same concept. Multiply top and bottom here by x squared minus 4, here x squared minus 3x plus 2. And again, if we have large degree polynomials in the denominator, this will become impractical. So we have to find an easier way of doing these problems. So what we're going to show you is this. If you take the previous problem, which is 61 over 810, 53 over 150, and what if I gave you this additional fact that the 810 can be written in this manner and 150 can be written in this manner? Then, if you look, we don't need to multiply by the entire 150 because you already have a 2, you already have a 3. In fact, you have a lot more 3s here, but you're missing a 5. So perhaps just multiplying numerator denominator by a 5 is sufficient here, as opposed to having the whole 150. Over here, we have a 2, we only have 1, 3, and we have 4 3s total here, so we need 3 additional 3s. So 3 cubed multiply numerator denominator, the 5 squared is already there. So instead of multiplying 53 by 810, we only have to multiply by 27. And then we finish it off, multiply those two together, multiply those two together, and then add the top numerators. So you can see the problem becomes a little bit easier to do because we have smaller numbers to work with. Similarly, in the polynomials and the denominator here, if I told you that x squared minus 3x plus 2 is these two as factors and x squared minus 4 factors in this manner, then we can multiply top and bottom by the missing factors. And then it's just exactly what you've been doing before. And then you add like terms. So we get x times x is x squared. X times 2 is 2x. 5 times x is 5x. And 5 times 2 is 10. Over here we have x times x is x squared. X times 1, negative 1 is negative x. Negative 3 times x is negative 3x. Negative 3 times negative 1 is the positive 3. Do you remember what to do now? We just did that in the previous lecture, right? So go ahead and add like terms. Okay, x squared minus x squared. So that's just gone. Okay, 2x plus 5x, 7x minus x. That will make it a plus x. So that's 8x minus another. So that will be a plus 3x. So that'll make it 11x. And then 10 minus the 3, which will give you the 7. So you can see how if we knew what the factors are of the denominators, it will make it a little easier. So now let's concentrate on how we can go about getting those factors. Let's look at the terminology. In a product A times B, where A and B are any two mathematical objects we've studied so far, the individual terms A and B are called factors. The quantity AB can be referred to as a multiple of A or a multiple of B. So if you have A times something, then that's a multiple of A. If you have B times something, it's a multiple of B. So in general, many mathematical objects can be broken down and written as products of other objects that we are going to call factors. So for example, A is a multiple of itself because A can be written as 1 times A. 2A is a multiple of A because it's 2 times A. A squared is a multiple of A because it's A times A. AB is a multiple of A because it's A times B. So anytime you have A times something, so A times X plus 1 is a multiple of A. This is a multiple of A, multiple of A, multiple of A, because these are all objects which are A times whatever. So these are all multiples of A. So here's a question for you. If A is a mathematical object we've studied so far, then are there finite or are there infinite multiples of A? So think like 2, for example. I have 2 is a multiple of 2, 4 is a multiple of 2, 6 is a multiple of 2, 8 is a multiple of 2. So can you answer that question? Do you think there are finite or infinitely many multiples of an object? Well, good. Yes, there are infinitely many. All right, so we're going to make a definition, the mathematical object that can be written as a product of the multiplicative identity 1, and the object itself is called a prime object. So objects that are not prime objects are referred to as composite objects. So prime objects only have 1 and itself as its factors. So let's look at examples. So for example, 6. 6 is 2 times 3. So 6 is a multiple of 2. 6 is also a multiple of 3. So clearly 6 is not a prime number. 9 is 3 times 3. 24 is 4 times 6. 39 is 3 times 13. So all of these quantities are composite because they are multiples of smaller numbers. Whole numbers like 13, 7, 41, 43, these are all prime numbers because we cannot write them as product of two whole numbers larger than 1. 13 can be only written as 1 times 13, so it's a prime number. Let's look at polynomials. The polynomial x squared plus 3x plus 2 is the same as x plus 2 times x plus 1. You can check that by doing the multiplication. X times x is x squared. X times 1 is 1x. 2 times x is 2x, or total of 3x's. And 2 times 1 is 2. So these two factors multiply to give you x squared plus 3x plus 2. And therefore, it's a composite polynomial. However, just x plus 2 can only be written as 1 times x plus 2. Similarly, x plus 1 can only be written as 1 times x plus 1. So in fact, these two individually by themselves are prime, but x squared plus 3x plus 2 is a composite polynomial since it's product of these two polynomials. So here's more examples. X and x plus 1 are irreducible or prime polynomials, because we cannot factor x any further. Similarly, x plus 1 can only be written as 1 times x plus 1.